Hi, Blazing Yeti here. So I started GTA 5 in 2022 because I just moved from console to PC and I wanted to show people how easy it is to get started and make your first 2.2 million. Quick tip, everything I'm about to show you now can be done in an invite only session except for one thing at the end, but I'll talk about that a little bit later on. Also, I did everything here without buying a car, a bike or a gun. This is GTA, remember, so you can steal whatever you want. Take a car, see something nice, there you go. If you wanna buy yourself a nice fancy car, do that at the end. When you made millions, you'll be able to buy whatever you want. So first things first, get a new character. Once you've loaded into the session, you'll be awarded £2,000 randomly for just being a good player and not killing anybody. For me, this actually happened within a couple of minutes. If you don't get that and you're in a rush, just go rob a shop, give you about a grand. Simple stuff. So the first thing that I did, I went to the music locker just to access and unlock the submarine and just to make sure I know exactly how much it was and how much I needed to get to. Get a little cutscene.
First and fucking foremost, you're obviously going to need a submarine.
Once that's over, have a dance, do whatever you want, then go to the casino. Casino is the first place you should always start every day you log in. Come here, you only have to buy the membership once. The membership is go to the desk, buy the membership, it will cost you £500, and you will get 5,000 chips instantly. Plus you get 1,000 chips every day for just going to the casino. And you also get the best thing, the spin every single day. Spin that wheel, you never know, you might get lucky, you might win the car. Or, you know, you might get, like I did, 20 grand. Which is a nice good little chunk to start you off with. So once you've done your casino, you've got your spin, you've got your money out, right. Now we're going to go and start the treasure hunt. Bring up your phone, go to emails, and you should have an email there that gives you the location of the first clue for the treasure. Now go to the first location. It is random. It can be anywhere on the map, but you will get given a yellow circle to show you the rough location of it. When you get near to this, you'll hear this sound. Kind of like chimes. You'll hear these chimes when you get near to it. You'll find the first note and this will give you access to the locations of the next three clues. Now you can do these clues in any order. I always start at the top and work my way down. Right at the very top you will find the empty gun case near a tree. I actually drove past this the first time because I wasn't listening for the sound. So make sure you're listening out. The second one is under a broken shack next to the water. You'll be looking for a shovel in this location. Show you it right here on the map. And then the last clue is located in a cave in the mountain. Once again, you'll get a little area where you're supposed to go to. Just go to the area, follow the path up. You'll find this cave very easily. Then you'll be given the last location, which is where the gun is. This can go in a couple of different places. I've had it in a two or three different places before. Very easy. You're just looking for two dead guys on the floor with a box dug out the ground next to them. Simple stuff. So now you've found this sick looking revolver, all you need to do now is complete the challenge. You get 50 headshots, easy stuff. Once you get the 50 headshots, it will give you £250,000, which is a nice start to where we want to be at the end. If you're finding it hard to find people to kill for some reason, then you can do this one or two ways. You can do it like I did and just did it slowly throughout as I'm doing the rest of these challenges and stuff. Or you can just go down to the beach and have yourself a massacre and fight off 1,000 cops. Do what you want. So the next little challenge we're going to go and do is the serial killer mission. It's super easy as well. Just like the last one, we just have to go to a couple of locations, find some clues. This time though, you'll get 5,000 for each time you find a clue. Like the last one, you can do this in any single order. I did this one first. As you can see, it's the writing on the wall. You'll hear some strange whispering sounds as you get close to it. It's just a clue to show you where all of them are, like the last one. Then you want to go over to the airstrip in the desert, look in between some rubbish, and you will find a hand located on the floor. If you're having trouble finding it, just look at where I'm going now and you'll be able to see it very easily. Once again, you'll hear all that whispering noise and stuff. After you've got that one, head up to here on the map and you will find the machete stuck into the side of the shed. Easy stuff. When we get that, then we've got to go and find the second to last clue, which is on this building here. It is behind it. Just go around to the back of the building. You'll find a door with a bloody handprint on it. Just go up to that and inspect it. Once you've done that, you get to the last one. Now, the last one is a little bit trickier because it can be in multiple locations. I'll just put a quick image up now. These are the locations it can be in. For me, it was very simple. It was in the second location that I checked. As you see here, this is what the van looks like. Once you found the van with loads of bloody machetes in the back, you will then get text from a very pissed off serial killer saying he's going to come for you, but we're going to go to him. We're going to go back to the airport in the desert at night time. He can pop up at any moment, so just I always keep looking around behind me because he pops up behind. Shoot him in the face. That's one extra headshot if you haven't done the challenges yet, and you'll get the Navy revolver. Now you will get another headshot challenge with this one to kill another 50, and that will give you 200,000 completing it. You've just got 50,000 for collecting the gun, plus you've got 25,000 from all of the clues. In total, you've just got yourself 275 grand if you complete the challenge. There you go. Now, this next little hunt we're going to do, what we're doing is we're looking for a text from someone called Maud. What you want to do is go to Maud's house, and then as soon as you've gone to her house, she will text you pretty much instantly. Open that up, and then it will activate the start of the quest, and just wait a little bit longer, and you will get your first bounty pop up, and she will email you the face of the person you want to go find. Now, you're going to go and do 5 of these bounties. They can take a little bit of time to come through, so, you know, just have some fun, drive around the map. If you're new to GTA, just learn the locations of stuff and just drive around a little bit. They're very easy to go and actually find. You get a photo of them. When you get near them, they will actually show up a little icon above their head. Now, you've got 2 options here. You can either capture them, make them surrender, and take them over back to Maud, or you can just kill them. You get 5 grand for killing them, 10 grand for going to take them back to Maud. Honestly, the amount of money we're going to have at the end of this, it ain't worth the 5 grand. Just shoot them in the face. That's it. Job done. Collect the money. Get your next one. What we're really after here is once you've got your 5 kills or your 5 bounties, we're looking for the hatchet. Now, this is probably one of the best melee weapons in the game. I absolutely love running on a rampage with this thing. Once you've completed the 5 bounties, you'll get this location pop up. Once we've got the location, we go and collect it. And we get another challenge. This time it's not 50 kills, it's only 25 kills. And you get the bonus of having a rampage mode when you hit it, so you take less damage. Screen goes a little bit funny. You can chain these kills together. So you could do what I did. I went to the beach. Loads of people sit at the beach. So just one after another, hacked away, got my 25 kills. And then that gives you £250,000. So we're getting there. We've done pretty well so far. Now what we're going to go and do is we're going to go to school. Go into flight school. This was good for me because I am terrible at flying, and it gave me a lot of practice. But on the controller, easy. Fly any vehicle in this game, not a problem. When it comes to PC and you're trying to control this thing with a mouse, it is ridiculously hard for me. I'm sure a lot of you are going to laugh and find it really easy yourself, but for me, it was stupid hard. However, I only got gold in one of these and silver in one, and the rest of them I got bronze, and I still made over 200k by doing it. So really, really is worth doing this. One, it's worth it for the practice. 2, extra 200 grand, possibly more if you're better than me. Right, so then once we've done that, you should have at least around 1 million by now if you've done all of these steps properly. Now this last bit is the little bit where I said you might have to go into a non-private lobby, simply because when you're in a private lobby and you're searching for matches, it just doesn't pick up people because of the whole auto invite system and the way that works. It just doesn't like being in an invite only lobby. So you want to go back to a public lobby. Simple. Once you've gone back to a public lobby, boot up the jobs menu in pause menu, go and find whatever the 2x is, 3x is for this week. Mine was, I did this last week when it was short trips, was a mission that you had to do, which gave you 100,000 every time you completed it. Plus the completed just one, it gave you an extra 100,000. So, you know, you could quite easily just do 11 of those and you'd be there, but that's quite boring just doing the same thing over and over again. So I do advise just going through all the different triple monies, the double monies, just to, you know, one, have some fun with the game. You know, you don't want to be sat there doing the same thing over and over and over again. You want to try different things out. I mean, I was getting anywhere between 20k if I was losing, 50k if you were winning. So it's relatively good money. It's a lot more fun than just sitting there doing those CEO missions that everybody recommends, going over and over and over again, doing the same fucking 2 missions. I just can't do that. This way you've got multiple different missions you can do. Obviously they're the same concept, but they are different maps themselves. Then what you want to do is just keep grinding those. It took me an hour or two to get through these properly until I got another 1 million. Honestly, grinding out these is just much more fun than it is to just go and buy yourself a shark card. So once you get to the 2.2 million, you now are at the point where you can make unlimited amounts of money. I can't stress this enough. Do not waste any of that money you've just made. Save everything. Buy yourself a submarine. Watch my next video and we'll see what to do once you've brought the submarine how to do the heist first time, what you need to look for, and how to make it super easy. I even did it on hard mode, elite challenge, completed first time. It's just so easy once you know how to do it. Just before you leave, a pro tip: if you have got an Amazon Prime account, link it to your Rockstar account and you will get £1 million bonus within the first couple of days. That will get you to this 2.2 million a lot quicker. Or if you've already made the 2.2 million, it will just give you that extra bit of money, which, you know, who doesn't like free money? So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like and subscribe button. If you would have done anything different in this video, if you would have done different challenges, if you know any other ways of making money quicker, then please put that down in the comments. Let's get some chat going. Let's just help everybody get that money quicker. Thanks a lot. See you next time.